Ladies and gentlemen, please join us. First of all, I want to say that I'm super excited that you showed up tonight. Thank you. I'm not super excited to see many of you not dressed up for Purim. So warning, next year I want you dressed up. My friends, to you and everybody who's joining us online, we are going to begin the program with a very special guest who's here from Israel to visit us. About a year ago, last Purim, I read in the Israeli paper about this guy who made it into Guinness World Record for the longest Megillah ever created. The actual Megillah is right there on the table. So before you drink too much and before your hands are dirty with food, I ask that you go look at it because it really is beautiful. Avner Moria is here from Israel to talk a little about his Megillah and the process. Please welcome Avner. Thank you. And while he makes it to the stage, I want to mention two things. First of all, if you didn't notice, there's a photo booth to the side. Great pictures, makes you look amazing. So I recommend you taking it before the night is over. Avner, let's do it.
So it gives me about 40 seconds for each year I put into my Megillah. That's many years of work. And actually, the way I did it, I used a brush with like four hairs on it. I probably painted more than a million brush strokes in this scroll that you're going to see. I have one major, very important request. Please do not go to look at it with either beverages or food or anything, and please don't touch it because it's done on parchment. It is gold leaf, and it is sensual. You want to touch it, but please don't, because we all have oil in our fingertips. Tackle a thing like that. I came up with 75 images of the story. The story is like a play. And my first image of the scroll is my cast of characters. You'll see it's like any play that you go to, there's a whole bunch of, you know, wherever the actors are. They are there in the beginning. You'll see them all, including my two dogs, Lutiti and Mijuli, that I love very much. Mijuli is in already a different stage in her life. She passed away a year ago during COVID. But I figured Ahasuerus was a major king in Persia. He had to have hoods to go to his hunting expeditions. So I added them into the Megillah. They're sleeping next to him when he wakes up in the middle of the night and he wants the history to be read to him. Blutiti and Mijuli are lying next to him. Here they have a golden bed. In reality, it was a plastic bed. But they don't care. And so for the text, I broke up to image after image. The category I applied for was the biggest. So I said, okay. The biggest scroll is 19.59 meters big, but they meant square meters, and I thought linear. I'm totally dyslexic, so it makes sense that I would think one thing and they would mean a different. The difference between linear and square is two little chumchiks over the sign of meters and squares. So I finished this scroll, it's 28.3 centimeters long. 28 meters is the length of a basketball field. That's long. And when you do it with a four-hair brush, it would take you a while, like it took me. So I submitted, and there isn't a category for the longest. But the guys were so impressed by my achievement, I decided they're going to have a special category, new category made for the longest scroll of Esther. So I think of my mother, she's 94 years old, and I always struggled with my dyslexia and stuff, and she always said, Avner, you're so special, don't worry what people think or say about you. So now even the Guinness Committee agrees that I have a category of my own, so they agree that I am special. So not only I have the Guinness Book of Records for the longest scroll of Esther, but I have a record for being special. And from now on, I'll keep it going. And I will put on my beard again, so if you don't recognize me, it's because I have my beard. Thank you for all coming here, and we should have a real great party.
Guys, Avner will be with us all night. He can answer any question. Please make sure you take a look at the Megillah that is
right over the table.
Our MCs for tonight, they will MC the Megillah reading. The costumes, for those of you who are to wear their costume, a costume contest where we're going to give two tickets to Moulin Rouge. I already think I know who's winning. And they are going to take care of the party. You know them, for they are a funny couple from Canada. You know them by watching 3 million hits on YouTube. They've been working with Mayim Bialik, with Howie Mandel, and our own Kenter. They are here specifically from Canada to be with us. Let's laugh, let's welcome Eli and Jamie.
Laser. Sorry I'm late.
I don't have a lot of time. I have to be back at the hospital in an hour.
Yes, my mother told me that your mother told her that you're a neurosurgeon. Very impressive.
Your mother didn't mention what you do.
Freelance.
Okay, so as our mothers may have discussed, I'm interested in leading a traditional Jewish life. I'm seeking candidates. I know exactly what to ask right off the bat, so blind dates is just a more efficient way of, you know, seeing if this is even possible. You understand.
Totally get it. Fire away.
Well, the first question is a new one. What's he doing here?
Oh, hey, yeah,
Is my husband showing dein King Hater?
Machen und Stau, als du bist der Coin. Weil bis geht schlacht, schlacht mich nach Haus. Weil bis geht geht, schlacht sich nach Haus.
Was kriegt ihr von der?
Wer macht von dir die Steine für die letzte drei Jahre zu kriegen?
Das geht.
You're out front and never seen a kosher California roll, so.
Are you Jewish?
Depends on your definition.
Of course he's Jewish. We went to Hebrew school together for 17 years.
That's not a black and white question.
What's your name?
Jaime.
Single?
Depends on your definition.
Okay, let's get started. How do you feel about children? Yes, no, how many?
Excellent question. I'd like at least two children, possibly three, God willing, at least a boy and a girl, so as the Talmud says, to replace ourselves on earth and continue the traditions of our fathers and matrilineal descent.
Good. And you?
I just came for the sushi.
You don't want children?
I might want. I don't know. I think the question in and of itself is ridiculous.
Excuse me?
Well, I mean, you're looking for a potential spouse here. Is the relationship between the two of you not going to play into any of this?
I'm going to get there.
The other one is that you have no time.
He has mild hypoglycemia, actually.
Can I have some sushi? No, I appreciate the honesty. How do you feel about eating kosher? In, out of the house?
Well, you see, the Bible was written by a cabal of sages, let's call them, who used a story and narrative based in Bronze Age polytheism.
I'm so sorry, my mother is calling. I better get this.
Hello, Ma. The house will finished. Yeah. This house was against the slide. This house was his will, as a Betty, a gay coming.
So sorry. My mother, too, I got it.
Yeah.
Your mommy, children me over with full gliding. Steichigkeit is erotisch.
Sie ist nicht für dich, sie ist für mich.
Versteht,
Mama.
Gott hat mir zwei Schmetterlinges, wo es meinen, als ich weiblich in die Welt und Pater in unserer Zeit.
I'll call you back.
A romantische Nacht.
A lange Shabbos Mahlzeit und danach a total mitzvah.
Netflix und Chillet.
Drei Wörter, was beschreiben euren Besten.
Hedonist, Atheist, Feminist.
Jede Woche.